And a good evening, everybody. Thank you so much for clicking play and joining me, Jewel, with this tropical update. For today, of course, being Thursday, the 14th of May, 2020. This is the latest thing from the National Hurricane Center, the latest graph model. This is set on 2 days. You can see now it's up to 70%. 60 to 70% chance of forming. And this, we might as well go ahead and click on the 5-day graph right quick. And let's see what it's looking like. Some things have changed, as you can see right here. We got that arrow going up right in this area a little bit more. Looking like we might have some changes right in here for all of us high tiders out on the outer banks and inner banks of North Carolina. Now, it's looking like, as of now, you know how these things change. A trough of low pressure over the Straits of Florida right now is producing a large area of cloudiness and thunderstorms. Environmental conditions, though, are expected to become conducive for development. Now, this system is likely to become a tropical or subtropical storm by late tomorrow or early Saturday when it's located near the northwestern Bahamas. Now, the system is looking like then it's going to move generally northeastward over the western Atlantic early next week. Regardless of development, the disturbance has the potential to bring heavy rainfall to portions of the Florida Keys, southeast Florida, and the Bahamas through Saturday. Now, I know a lot of southeastern Florida has been dry, even had some brush fires going on. This rain will help you guys out there when you get it. Now, other than that, it's looking like you could have some tropical storm force wind gusts. They're possible in the Florida Keys, southeast Florida, and the Bahamas also during the next day or two. Hazardous marine conditions are also expected along the Florida East Coast and in the Bahamas where gale warnings are in effect. Now, in 2 days, 70% chance, 5 days, 80% chance. This is what it's looking like right now. Well, check out a few model readings. I'm going to use my Fox models for this particular forecast. One thing I do want to say, I'm not going to do it today, but this thing looks like it may kind of hang around here for a while off of our coast of NC. And if it does, it could make a little bit of flooding up in the Neuse and the Pamlico rivers, and along with rip currents all the way up, probably from the Jersey Shore all the way down through Florida. Rip currents are going to be with us for the next few days. So if you are out and about, please keep this in mind. Now, first of all, we're going to look at the European model, okay? So let's just start clicking it through a little bit. You can see the timestamp. You can see what's happening right here. Timestamp's right down here for you guys. So you can see nothing going on yet, but then, boom, here we go. The 17th. We have some right in here. It looks like it degrades some, and I think that's because it's going to run into shear wind. Where it's located right now is where the water is the warmest also. It can't get but so close. It'll get up closer to us, like, but it's going to have some things in its way, okay? So here we go. We're at the 18th now. Let's just go up to the 19th. As you can see, it downgrades already because it's getting into shear wind, and it tried to get a little closer, but the water was cooler, and it's downgraded a little bit, looking like on the 19th here. Then, here it is. It gets pushed out to sea because we got another system coming through, pushing it out. This is high pressure. That's what's keeping it bound up in here as it is right now. So this is the 20th. See how the high pressure is just keeping it. It's out in warmer waters now, though, by the 21st, and you can see it tries to reorganize better with more isobars around it where they're tightly compacted there. Here's a 22nd. High pressure here. It's got kind of squished in between. Right in here, it's in warm water. It's trying to take off and to develop into something more than we want. But then it gets sucked up by the high pressure and starts to disintegrate again. By the 24th, it's no big deal at all. It's wrapped up in the high pressure. And here we are back on the 14th today for the European model. Now let's check out the GFS. A lot of people go by this. I kind of go by all of them, and then I kind of put them all together and make my own formula up, as you know, if you followed me over the years. So here we go with this right now. Some seem to be a little more reliable than others, but you have to really actually put them all together. Timestamp up here for the GFS model. As we click on through, we can see it start now out about 36 hours. Really weak right there, but it's trying to make up, and it does, as you can see. And by 51 hours out from now, right off the coast of the Bahamas and off the coast of Florida, it is getting more organized at this time as it moves on through. Now, you can see it got organized. It kind of died down. Now it's getting organized again. We're going to check out the shear wind in a moment. Right now, though, the pressure is 1,010. Here's this high pressure over in here, just pushing it up in here. Here's another high pressure out in here. It's kind of trapped. Don't know what to do, where to go. It's in the warm water. If it gets in the cool water, it knows it's not going to do anything. Here we go. The pressure's still 1,008. As we move along, you can see we're going to get a little bit of the outer edge along the inner and outer banks. Maybe as far as Wilmington. No big deal. My main concern with this is just going to be if it pushes the water up. Now, you can see it gets a little better, and the pressure goes down. It's still in warm water. The center here is not right up here. If it was up there, it wouldn't last as long because the water's not quite as warm as where it is here. Then on out. Now, at 102 hours out, this is my greatest concern. The day before and the day before, and then when it gets up here, we may get some rain out of this along eastern North Carolina. You guys over here in Georgia and western North Carolina, South Carolina, all up in these areas, this area here, this is probably just going to bring you some rain at this time. It has nothing to do with this system here. Arthur, I think it may get the name Arthur, though, because, see, it got a little too close. So it started to move out some with the pressure now back in warm water at 1,006. As it's moving on up the coast, we'll click it on through. You can see what's happening. It gets right to go out to sea. This is what it's looking like now. It gets out to sea, dies on down. As it's high pressure, the GFS and the European models agreeing on this now at 180 hours out. Here's the system. This high pressure starts to, like, absorb it. See how the pressure's rose to 1,016 now? And then there she blows. It's all gone, okay? You don't have to worry about that system anymore. But we're going to check some more on it. So far as shear wind goes, that's what this map is showing. And you can barely make the system out, but it's right in here. Okay, but it's in like some 30 to 35 mile per hour shear winds at 54 hours out, as you can see. That's what's going to make this not become a full-fledged tropical storm or possibly even a Category 1 hurricane. But this shear wind's going to help tear it apart, as you can see. And as we get on out, it looks like it's staying in shear wind for the most part. It's still right up in here. Just one little quadrant doesn't have any shear wind in it, but it still has some. It's slacking up some. It's anywhere from 15 to 30 mile per hour shear winds that it's going to be going through, though. And when we get up to 72 hours, that's as far as we can go. Here's our coastlines in here. You can see it's still in at least 25 to 30 mile per hour shear winds. Now, as we look at the radar reflectivity with the wind vectors, you can see, now this is the WRF model. Here's our system. It's going to hang around here for tonight. Probably it's going to be either late Saturday or Sunday before it gets up here and really starts to form more than it is right now, being this area of low, broad, low pressure system. But we're going to click this through and let you see. You can see it's still got 1,018 millibars in it at this time. This is 5 hours from now. This goes up to 72 hours. I'll click it on through right quick for you. Now it's starting to form a little bit right in here. Just a little bit. But it gets a little more compact, as you can see. Why? Because it's in very warm water. It's in very, very warm water. Now it's really taking off about 27 hours from now, looking like it's really getting forming into a good subtropical system. Now it looks like it is possibly a tropical system, and boom, what happens? It hits some of that shear wind, and some of these isobars are not tightly compacted as they were, and you can see the pressure has risen in it. But we'll click on up a little bit here, move it on up a little bit faster, looking like it does try to get through a little bit of the shear wind and form better, but it's still having a hard time. These things are not compact tightly enough to make it any more severe. So we'll get up here to 72 hours is as far as it goes. You can see it has been pushed out a little bit now, trying to stay in the warm waters. What it's doing, it is trying its best, folks, to form into a super duper storm. But this high pressure's taken over. We have high pressure over here. It don't have a lot. It's getting squeezed. That's why it's back out in the warm water. This high pressure has pushed it here. This is pushing it here. That's why it's going to ride off the coast here for a bit. So we have to take all of this into consideration. Later on this week, probably Monday, if I need to do it sooner, I will. I have another model for the waves that I can go to and pinpoint some areas such as the Neuse River, the Pamlico River, all of these places, the Albemarle Sound as well as the Pamlico Sound. But this is a wave graph, and we're just going to go by this now. You can see this is how the feet are in them, and here is your timestamp. So let's just move it on up. We got to find the system first. Here we go. You can see the water is going to start to pile in. Here we go. Water is coming on up in these areas now. As you can see, but right around in here, we got about 4.5 to 5 feet waves, okay? You can see right over here. That's what this is, and that's what's going to be pushing inland up into the creeks and the rivers and every little ditch that you can find to fill up when it kind of just hangs off the coast here. That's my main concern with this. Yes, we may get a little rain out of it. The wind's not going to be that bad. Nothing we haven't been through before. Nothing that we can't handle. Unless things change. Like I said, things can change. But don't be alarmed by this. But just be aware that this may happen about 96 hours from now. And it'll probably start before that. And then it's going to move on out. Going to have some waves. Probably some good waves up around the Jersey shoreline. Down here in the Delmarva Peninsula area. So you could have some good waves coming in this area too. And this is a check of what possibly could be Arthur, whether it's subtropical or tropical. I think it just might get the name Arthur before it's all over said and done. I'll keep my eyes on it for you. Everybody, be aware of this. You live anywhere up and down the coastline here. You know how the weather is. It's real fickle and it could change. But this is what it's looking like right now. And it's never too soon to prepare for a hurricane if you live on the eastern coast. I don't care where you live. So keep that in mind. Have a plan. Have a kit. Know what you're going to do. If anything happens like flooding or anything pertaining to a tropical storm or a hurricane comes to your area. So with that all said and done, this is what it's looking like. I think it will develop. I think it probably has a very good chance of getting a name at some point. But that's to be seen. We'll have to wait and see what happens. Have a good evening, a safe evening, a blessed evening. Thank you so much for watching and everything you do for me. I love you guys. Stay safe for me. Peace, love, and kindness to all.